also filthy wicked spirits, man. Because what cleanses you? The word cleanses you, man. Taking heed to the words of Yahweh by Shem Yahusha, that's what cleanses you, ultimately. Okay, so there our people are filthy, disgusting, dirty as hell on this side. And why? Because they reject the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Heavenly Father. Okay? So that's why they dusty ass walking up here now, man. And that's another reason why some of them are stink. Because I say cleanliness and exegologist, man, so the scripture, you are supposed to even clean yourself, man. A lot of people walk around here just musty as hell.
This is Haggai chapter 1, verse 6. Ye have sown much and bring in little.
And that's how people, they sown much and bring a little, man. They stay working, people be getting 2 and 3 jobs. Still can't make ends meet sometimes.
Right? Let's talk that over again. This is Haggai 1, verse, chapter 6. This is Haggai chapter 1, verse 6. Ye have sown much and bring in little.
Right. And also because of slavery, man. Our people have completely built up America, man. First off, it started with the you Judites, the so-called Negroes, okay, in chattel slavery, all right? The biggest export of America at that time was cotton. So we catapulted America pretty much overnight, man, because of free labor. So he's sawing hella much. And then all of a sudden, you Latin tribes, now they got you in the construction jobs, building up every building like Legos, whooping y'all back, in a sense. Because you look up, there's one building that's not there, and all of a sudden, a month and a half later, it's completely finished.
Well, it's done in 3 months, right?
You know, I'm like, damn. So they on you letting tribes ass right now, and they don't bring in much either. Okay, so we saw months, we working hard as hell, working our fingers to the bone, blood, sweat, and tears, and don't have shit to show for it, man. Still on the bottom. They still look at you as nothing. But we got all the inventions, okay? Because we doing all the work, so we figure out ways to make the stuff run more smoother and have a make it an easier process, and then what they do, they patent it, take the idea, say they created it, because they own the slaves, or they just outright rape you for your idea and find a loophole, and then Esau makes the money off of it. Okay?
Go ahead.
Ye eat, but ye have not enough. Ye drink, but ye are not filled with drink. Ye clothe you, but there is none warm.
So I can start that over one more time, bro.
This is Haggai chapter 1, verse 6 from the top. Ye have sown much, but bring in little.
Right, people sow much and bring in little, man. Work hella overtime. Okay? Still, because of the curses, man. Go ahead. And they refuse to consider their ways. Now people refuse to see, understand, or look into why they're in a condition. That's our people's problem, man. They don't ask why. They just like, it is what it is, and they accept it. You know, go ahead.
Ye eat, but ye have not enough.
You eat, but you have not enough, man. Now, some of you may have RFP food stamps and that type of stuff, okay, but you're not full spiritually, man. You're not whole. Our people walk around here void of spirit, man. Walk around empty inside, trying to find anything they can to fill that void. And mostly through other philosophies and beliefs, man. And that's why they wax worse and worse. Go ahead.
Ye drink, but ye are not filled with drink. Ye clothe you, but there is none more.
Man, so that's pretty much no comfort on this side, man. There is no rest. Right? That's why we're not to push ourselves wholeheartedly in society, spiritually, man. Because this ain't our rest. This place wasn't set up for you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, man. This place was set up as a jail cell. This is the ultimate prison for y'all, man.
That's right.
For us as well. We in this place too, man. Okay, why? Because you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans went off, man. So now you in this big ass prison, looked down upon.
Yep.
You're the butt of every joke now.
Yeah.
Okay? They look to you for comedy.
That's right.
Oh, Keisha, she's so real. She tells it like it is. They just want you're a song and dance to them, man. You know, you got Jake, the men around here acting a damn fool and trying to be the class clown and shit, the funny guy. Okay, goddamn bo japing around here, man. It ain't funny, man. You Negroes, they hate you niggas, man.
That's right.
All right, they hate you Mexicans. They hate you Native Americans. They shoot you down the streets, man. They giving y'all hell in the Dakotas right now with that pipeline.
Yeah,
hitting right. Y'all ass with water hoses.
Yeah.
Okay? Hey, man, the timeout for games is over with, man.
That's right.
Why the Most High is killing a lot of people every day in and day out now, man.
That's right.
It's a time of judgment right now.
That's right.
All right, and the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashim Yahusha, who you ended call God and Jesus, is mad as hell in America, man.
That's right.
And America's about to play for all the wickedness that they have portrayed upon the people of the Lord, man.
That's right.
Go ahead, bro.
And he that earneth wages to put it into a bag with holes.
Right, he that earned the wages earned it to just to put in the bag with holes, man. So it falls out the bottom, man. Brothers up here can attest to that. You know, that's why certain brothers may have another side hole or something, because hell, you got so many holes in your bag, man. You can't never, most everyone's living check to check, man.
Yeah.
Most, if one bad thing happens, really screws you up, you assed out, man. You're about to lose your apartment, man.
That's right.
Or your house.
That's right, Alex.
If one thing happens where you got to pay like $2,000 out the ass, you done, man.
Hey.
I think the survey said no. Most people don't even have, what, $1,500 in their savings account.
Yeah.
You know? But that's how it's set up here for you Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, man.
Right.
You're cursed.
Oh, that shit, yeah.
This is Romans chapter 13, verse 11. And that, knowing the time, that now is high time to awake out of sleep.
Right, knowing the time, man. What time are we in right now, man? That's how people fail to realize, man. Our people still walk around here, want to do whatever they want to do, man. Really, whatever your heart's desire is, feel whatever lust that America taught you to chase after, man. Not thinking on things of the Heavenly Father, man. Not paying attention to the signs and the times, man. Not paying attention that people are dying all around us. All right, day in and day out, the scriptures say that the Lord's judgment, he brings the judgment to light every day, man. Loosely paraphrasing. But the unjust, no shame, man. So our people don't even pay attention to those things. That's why it's time for people to wake out of sleep, man. All right, because the time we're in a time of judgment, like I mentioned earlier, man. All right, World War III is getting closer and closer to coming to a head. That chip is here. Okay, it's only a matter of time for they start enforcing that to be mandatory. All right, there's already an article, brother, but not about certain jobs going to start having people take that, man.
Yeah, like in Sweden, they had 150 employees taking it for free.
Yeah, they took it for free, man.
Yeah.
And they big that up. You know how easy it is and for convenience and stuff, which that's all they're doing.
Yeah,
they pushing the people right towards to get that chip, man. They feed you McDonald's, okay, Whataburger, Subway, all right, Williams Chicken, Rudy's Chicken. They put all that crap in your niggas' hoods, man, to dumb you down. Then they make everything hella annoying, so you look for everything as something that's more convenient. And that's after they just bring your ass right to the slaughter, man. All right?
Good. It says, for now is our salvation nearer than we believe.
Right, the salvation of the elect is nearer than we believe, man. The coming of the Lord is nearer than we believe. Okay, give me a second, address 9:1.
Go ahead. It says, the night is far spent. The day is at hand.
All right, the night is far spent, man. All right, the day is at hand, what? The day of the Lord, which is the scriptures described as being terrible, man. You got our people in church telling me they can't wait till the Lord come back. All right, if you knew what we knew, you want to delay that coming a little bit to get your affairs in order, man. Why are you trying to hasten the day?
Go ahead, bro. It says, let us therefore cast off the works of darkness.
Right, that's what we're out here to tell our people to do, man. Cast off the works of darkness, man. Repent and turn back to the law, statutes, commandments of the Heavenly Father. All right, to put off Christmas, to put off sweet baby Jesus. Okay, to put off worshiping your damn woman, man. Put off worshiping yourself. Okay, those are all works of darkness here, man. Why? Because this place is the land of the shadow of death, man.
Yep.
Go ahead. It says, and let us put on the armor of light.
The armor of light, man. And what's the light? When you read Proverbs, the 6th chapter, it tells you that the law is a light.
Yeah.
The scriptures is a light, man. That's why if you don't speak according to the light, according to this word, there's no light in you, man. Because if you're not coming out of this book, then you up shit's quick without a paddle, man.
Right.
That's why the elect are going to be justified, because they do nothing but try to speak the words of Yahweh by Shema Shah.
Go ahead.
It says, let us walk honestly as in the day, not in riding.
Riding means partying all the time, man. Hitting the bar, hitting, still clubbing, man. All right, it's 2017, niggas still going club, man. Niggas walk around Dallas, they're still trying to have a good time and act like they the shit, man. The Most High is killing the spirit of this place, man. You can look at this place, man.
Yep, right.
This place is dead, man.
Yeah, right.
much swag as hell, man. So it say, walk honestly in the day, man, in the light, in honesty, man, to the best of your abilities.
Go ahead.
It says, not in rioting and drunkenness.
Rioting, drunkenness, okay, getting hammered, getting plastered out in the streets, acting a damn fool, man. That's our people, man. Always creating a world star moment out to the damn club. Drunk as hell, trying to prove their manhood. Or women fighting over another dude, man. You know? That's drunkenness. Also spiritual drunkenness, man. Our people are spiritual alcoholics here. Drunk as hell walking around here, man. Drunk off the philosophy of the so-called whites.
Hella drunk, right?
Yeah, see right there, look.
Ah, man. It always manifests in front of us every time.
That's right. Always give an example, man.
That's right.
Every time.
Walking around in drunkenness, man. Drunk as hell. On a damn Tuesday night in downtown. That's our people, man. Huh? Yeah. Yeah.
Drunk
as hell. Probably like a 6'3" bottle of gin, man.
It says, not in chambering.
Not in chambering, okay? Trying to pop every damn thing, man. That's what chambering means. And nobody say you can't have a woman, but at this time, man, you gotta calm down.
Yeah.
You know, hell, half these women are fucking men anyway, so you wanna be careful.
That's
trying to be the goddamn man, you're gonna end up popping a dude. Show you how cold the Most High is, man. Projected don't wanna rule their spirit. We got to be temperate in all things, man.
That's right, brother.
We come to a time where the Most High will smoke you. He's smoking people in outrageous ways now, bro. That's so where it's right, like, bro. God damn, he can't even make this shit up.
Hey,
what's a good point? We had mentioned it earlier, man. The leader of the LGBT, that whole movement of making the flag, man, the nigga croaked, man.
Yeah, that dude, Most High made that dude kick the bucket, man.
That's right.
He finally got tired of them making a mockery of the covenant that he made in the Genesis 9th chapter, how he wasn't going to flood the earth anymore, man. That's what the rainbow was made for. It wasn't made for same-sex marriages, man. For men to love men and wear it as a belt, man.
That's right, brother.
Or wear it as a handkerchief in your damn suit at church, man. The Most High didn't make it for that, man.
Yeah.
He made it for a holy covenant.
That's right, brother.
That he made with his people, man. But this America, what does America do? They trample all over everything that the Heavenly Father has set up, man. And that's why this place is gonna be destroyed, man. It needs to be destroyed yesterday.
It says, not in chambering and wantonness. Not in strife and envying.
Right, wantonness, man, being undisciplined. That's another major trait of our people, man. They don't ever follow through with nothing, man. That's why they made that song, the Boondocks, when the MLK even cursed them niggas out, man. Even if that homo was so he cursed you niggas out looking at how y'all looking today, man. You know, being lazy niggas, man. And that's our people, man. Yeah, we call our people niggas too, man. We give it to everybody. If you ain't right, we're going to give it to you in the spirit, man.
That's right.
We give it to ourselves in the spirit, man. There is no respect of persons amongst the men of the Lord. Okay?
Start off at wantonness again.
It says, not in chambering and wantonness, mm-hmm. Not in strife and envying.
Strife and envy, man. That's heavy amongst our people, man. You can't even walk down the street and make eye contact with a guy that looks like you because he giving you a scowl. He's looking for a reason to start some beef with you, man.
Yep.
And then all of a sudden our people are envying one another, coming after what another man has, especially when it comes to your woman.
That's right.
Okay, they do nothing but envy you for your woman and what you got, man, instead of going to get their own stuff, man. The ratio of women is already like 7 to 10 to 1.
That's ridiculous.
And then you add in all the men that are homosexuals.
Locked up.
50 to 1
now. Yeah, men locked up. You know, so there's tons of women out there, man. But Jake always want to envy you and try to get your woman. All these lonely big-head women walking around here, man, but he wants yours. It's already taken. You know, that's envy and strife, man, but that goes back to the curses, man, for not obeying the law, statutes, and commandments of the Heavenly Father, man. So now look at it. We walk around in America looking crazy as hell.
That's
right.
It says, but put ye on the Lord, Yahushua HaMashiach, and make not provision for the flesh.
Man, make not provision for the flesh, man. So put on Yahweh Shem Yahushua, man. Let that mind be in you, which is also in Yahweh shop, man. He wasn't going after the flesh. He was always staying spiritual, man. Looking at spiritual things, man. And our people, that flesh represents your wants and desires, man. Okay, what you want, what makes you feel good, and what makes you feel good, man. And that's all this was pushed here in America. Okay, feed your flesh, in a sense. Okay, obey, we always go down this, obey your thirst. Hungry, why wait? There's no patience here, no prudence being uplifted here, man. It's all about rash decisions. Okay, acting like a damn beast, man, our pure instinct. We're not thinking about any type of logic, man, about how this can affect you or your family a year down the line, a week down the line, tomorrow. Our people don't ever think about that, man. That's why their ass is always broke. That's why a damn hustler is all a nigga that sell weed and always hustling, he always broke.
Yeah, I understand a hustler broke, right?
Yeah, a nigga hustler, but he ain't never got no damn money.
Yeah, man, don't got a car.
You hustling, but you on the corner with no car, man. You know, like the states, you know, dude said, Minister Saudi, all y'all sell that dope, but y'all ain't got no money. Niggas don't have money to put in gas in the car, man. Perfect.
Hey, Akia, you know? Got all the women in the world, but ain't got nowhere to lay your head.
Yeah.
That's how Jake went.
That's how people, man. You a Mac, but you fucking checking up with your homeboy. but you such a Mac, and you so damn smart and cool and suave and sly and ingenuitive and all that other stuff. You know what you can't, niggas can't hold down a damn job, man.
Hey. Go ahead, bro. It says, this is about the end of it, though. It says, and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust.
Make not provision for the flesh to fulfill your lust, man. Because that lust is going to get you killed today, man. That's why the scripture said to be carnally minded is an enmity with the Most High, man. And it's to be in a dead state. Okay?
Anybody have anything?
Hey, Jesse. This is 2 Esdras, chapter 9, beginning at verse 1. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself.
Right, so that's why we're out here so hard on our people, man. That's why we out here cursing Jake out, man. Sometimes Jake needs to be belittled, man. Jake needs to be brought down on the taste, man, because for some reason, Jake think they the big shit here in America. And they on the complete bottom getting shitted on. So sometimes you have to go hard at our people, man. Why? Because of timing. Because we the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahushua has gave us the knowledge and the tools to measure down the time diligently, man. To see what time we need. That's why I say through the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. That's why we out here screaming at the top of our lungs week in and week out, man. Because we see the death toll is about to rise tremendously, man. Apostle R said tens of millions of Israelites is going to die, man. He coined that phrase.
That's right.
And that's true, man. That goes to the two-thirds of our people being put to death. And then just the scriptures say the slain of the Lord shall be many, so our people are going to be dropping dead all around us pretty soon, man. When we come to that time with Jacob's trouble.
Go ahead. When thou seest part of the... Salakia. And when thou seest part of the signs past, when I have told thee before, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
Right, and that's what's happening right now, man. We're seeing most of the signs that already passed already. Okay, so now we're seeing that Yahweh Shem Yahushua is visiting the planet Earth right now. All right? He's making good his promise, man. He's starting to kill a lot of people, man. He's starting to jack up this society, man. He's starting to break up America, man. Even these other Israelite groups that are coming up against GMS, man, he's starting to break all that up, man. Okay, assholes are being exposed left and right.
Yes.
Niggas are quitting. Okay, other churches are getting broke up by the feds.
Yeah.
You know, all these things are happening around us, man. And Yahweh Shem Yahushua promised it, man. We're seeing the signs, man. So we know we're that much closer to the end, man. That's where even the so-called white man, he's being backed in the corner. He's gonna go crazy, man. He's gonna go ape shit on Jake. Go ahead.
Therefore, when thou shalt be seen. Verse 3. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, thou shalt well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning.
Right, so we see earthquakes in diverse places, man. Every other day, your RT app has an earthquake hitting somewhere. Okay, uproars of the people. Okay, people still riding over there overseas in Europe. Okay, people are losing it over here in America now. Okay, you got this Black Lives Matter, even though it's all BS. You got some people that are really believing that matters, man, having uproars, man. Go ahead.
For like as all that is made in the world hath a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest.
The end is manifest, man. the end of this age, man, the end of Esau's rulership is being manifested, man. The end of America is being manifested. Okay, this place is crumbling from the inside out. Okay, now, and that's a beautiful thing, man. But that's the problem with our people, man. Most of you Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans don't want this place, don't want this place to be destroyed, man. Because it allows you to be the asshole that you are. Okay, it allows you to give a provision to the flesh, man.
Like I said, brother, that's why when Jacob always comes to the defense of the so-called white man, Esau, man. You always come to the defense of him. All these other nations gonna be of people, these heathen gonna be destroyed, but the white man needs to be saved. You know why the we know, like your brother beautifully broke down. That's why you want the white man to make it, so you can be under his rule, man.
Keep getting that paycheck.
Yeah, keep getting that paycheck. But the Lord, like the brother said, the Lord about to hit our people even more and more harder, man.
Yeah, man, Jake don't have no rulership mentality, man. They want to be a damn slave on their life, man.
That's right.
Okay?
Let's go to Jeremiah chapter 2.
Wisdom of Solomon 7 and 16. For in his hand are both we and our words, all wisdom also and the knowledge of workmanship. For he hath given me certain knowledge of the things that are namely to know how the world was made and the operations of the elements, the beginning, ending, and the midst of times.
It's not over.
Wisdom of Solomon 7 and 17. And 17. For he hath given me certain knowledge of the things that are namely to know how the world was made.
Right, this is Solomon, man. He gave him all the knowledge, man, because that's what he prayed for, to govern his people righteously, man. That's why he wrote the book of Ecclesiastes, the book of Proverbs, Wisdom of Solomon. Solomon was a bad dude, all right? Had people come from near and far just to hear him speak, man. And so he gave that, and so Yahweh Shemeshah gave him that knowledge, man, to break down certain animals, break down all types of things, man. And so he gave his men a little bit, a portion of the spirit inside, which we're going to get the full thing once we're delivered to be changed in the twinkling of an eye, Lord. Go ahead.
And the operations of the elements.
The operations of the elements, man, how all things work, man. Go ahead.
Because you're going into the beginning and the end of it.
Yeah.
The beginning, ending, and the midst of times, mm-hmm. The alterations of the turning of the sun,
right.
And the change of seasons.
The beginning, the end of, and the midst of times, man. So he prophesied. He understood the beginning of things. He understood the end. Okay? He understood what the Edomite judgments were. All right? He understood all those things, man. All right, and so the Most High told us these things through the scripture. So now that's the things that he passed down to us as well, man. Why? Because he has Solomon write it down along with the rest of the prophets. All right, so now we know that the things that happened from the beginning, in the middle, and what's going to happen at the end. Yeah. We know the end game, man. You know, so that's why two-thirds of our people, y'all can go ahead and continue to enjoy your night, man. You other heathen nations, the so-called white man, you so-called Japanese, you so-called Chinese, you so-called East Indians, you so-called Africans. Oh, Lord. Y'all gonna enjoy y'all night. and we understand why Yahweh Shemeshah did that, man. Okay? Why he made people look like that, man. You know, we were given that understanding, man. We don't feel bad because that man, you was a mark in your last life, man. You did something just ridiculously wicked to come out looking like that, man. Was that on that room?
No, that was it.
This is Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 13. And it reads, for my people have committed two evils.
Right. People have committed two evils, man. Because I was saying earlier, man, Jake doesn't have a rulership mentality, man. They're a bunch of damn slaves and a so-called white man scared to leave from his side, man. A bunch of house niggas, man. Go ahead. You're completely in love with a sick SOB that done nothing but show you hate, man. The more you fight for acceptance and equality, the more he hates you, man. Jace, our people wanted civil rights. They didn't even want equal rights. They wanted civil rights, and he sent big-ass German shepherds and water hoses on your ass, man. All right? He shot your so-called leaders down in the streets, man. He did everything he could to show hate against our people, man, but they steady trying to pull on his coattails.
What's it say, Jake Trim? Or what it say, Trim to seek love?
Man, that's what it's saying. Yeah, they trim their way to seek love, man. They trim their way, as far as being righteous, to seek love, man. Okay, go ahead.
It says, they have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters.
Hey, the second Yahweh Shira Shah, the fountain of living waters, man. That's why we call, when Jake Neal coming, boys, we call these niggas dehydrated, man. They don't have the actual water, man.
Right.
And they also walk around here delirious as hell, man. Hey, we go without water a long time, man. You get hella delirious, man. You start hallucinating. All type of shit start happening to you, man. That's how people, man, they're hallucinating around here, man. In a crazy ass state, because they don't have the actual water, man. They don't have the nourishment, and they're not hydrated. Go ahead.
And hewed out cisterns, broken cisterns.
Broken cisterns, man. Other philosophies, man. Go ahead.
That can hold no water.
That can hold no water, man. So even you guys that call yourself Israelites, man, you have broken cisterns. That's not holding on to the truth, man. Why? Because you refuse to go to the straight gate, man. You refuse to submit yourself. Okay, you refuse to put yourself second. And so that's our people, man. Go ahead.
It says, is Yasher Allah a servant?
Right, is Israel a servant? Go ahead.
Is he a homeborn slave?
Right, are we homeborn slaves? Were we supposed to be in slavery? Go ahead.
Why is he spoiled?
Why are we spoiled, man? No, we weren't supposed to be. No, we're not homeborn slaves. We weren't set up to be in captivity. We were set up to rule the nation. We were set up to be a beacon of righteousness to show the rest of the world how to live. Now, we followed after the rest of the world.
Right.
And then everybody else a madness, man.
Like I said, if you don't mind, if we the tail.
Yeah, if we the tail now, man. All right, so that's why I believe in Jeremiah 11 said, according to thy cities of Judah are thy gods, man. Jake is into everything under the sun, man. Anything that make Jake sound smart to bag a broad, that's what they into, man. To make them seem smart in the barbershop, that's what they into, man.
That barbershop logic.
Yeah, that barbershop talking in the barbershop regurgitating all type of madness, man. All right, and that's why we're spoiled now. That's why we appear to be homeborn slaves, man. Because why? We read the scripture above. It said we sacrificed the living waters, man, which is Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shah.
That's right.
So now look at us. We're in captivity now. Go ahead.
I think that's
right.
This is Ezekiel chapter 6 and 11. We was talking about how the Lord's about to implement judgment, and Apostle Paul was saying how hundreds of thousands of Israelites are about to be put to death and judged. He said, thus said Yahweh power, smite with thine hand and stamp with thy foot and say, alas. It's Ezekiel chapter 6 and 11. It says, thus said Yahweh power, smite with thine hand and stamp with thy foot and say, alas for all the evil.